Greetings, folks, and welcome to another OrchestralTemplates.com gear overview. I hope you're doing absolutely fantastic. I'm Tobias from OrchestralTemplates.com, where you'll find custom template solutions for working composers. Today we'll be looking at Capsule, the scripting framework behind Orchestral Tools collections. Full disclosure, I work for Orchestral Tools as the guy for support, QA, documentation, and other impressively important stuff. And this video is the answer to the number one question both Orchestral Tools customers and my own Orchestral Templates clients ask me all the time. What is Capsule and how do I use it? This video is made by me, it is not an official Orchestral Tools video and does not represent an official resource. In this video, we will be dealing with what Capsule is, briefly, which features it offers, and how you use it to the fullest. We will of course be dealing with specific Orchestral Tools collections for demonstration purposes and to show practical examples, but everything in this video generally applies to all collections and is universal. If you're looking for reviews about the collections discussed, there are plenty of great and unbiased resources out there. By the way, the term collection is just a really fancy way of saying sample library. Because Orchestral Tools see their products as belonging together within the larger series, the term collection references this a bit better than just saying sample library. What is Capsule? Before we can see how it works, we need to clear up what Capsule actually is. Capsule stands for Control and Performance Symphonic Utility Engine, and it is the name for the script behind all Orchestral Tools collections. Capsule determines the look and feel of all patches and also encompasses a common feature set and workflow. So, if it is just the script, why does it have such a prominent name? After all, other companies do not call their contact code by some fancy title. The reason behind making Capsule kind of stand out as a separate entity is its whole concept. Rather than just being the code behind the instrument, the idea of Capsule is that it provides one coherent and consistent UI for all collections. All collections look and work the same and use the same feature set. In this capacity, Capsule in a way is its own entity as it sits above individual collections as a UI and workflow paradigm. But Capsule is not a separate application or purchase. It is part of every collection. The UI. Every Capsule patch has four views, that each are responsible for one specific part of the patch. The performance view shows important controls for the instrument and provides a visual reference of what is playing, what velocity layers are playing, and how articulations are controlled. Depending on the patch type, it looks completely different, so we will deal with it when looking at the individual patch types. The mixer view shows the mixer, go figure. Here you can control all microphone positions, dial in a mix, and route outputs. We'll deal with the specifics of that view later on, but in general it is a typical mixer with all the features you'd expect from one. The settings view controls settings for the whole patch. Which options will be available here depends on the patch. If an option does not show up here, the patch does not support it. Finally, the controller table is a central place for all things automation. Here you assign key switches or CCs to features, control reaction curves, and tailor the instrument to your liking. A tale of three patch types. In public discourse about Capsule, when people use the term, they generally refer to the multi-articulation patches, the ones with 12 slots where you can load stuff. While these are indeed part of Capsule, they are only half of what it is. The other half are the single articulation patches and their close cousins, the time machine patches. In most collections, you will find three folders with the three patch types inside the instruments folder. One important thing right at the start. Neither category is more important or more fully featured than the others. If you use only one patch type, you are missing out a huge lot. I'm looking at you, multi-users. Let's go through them one by one with a few examples. A. Single articulation patches. As the name implies, these patches generally contain a single articulation like sustain, staccato, or crescendo. They are most like the patches you might know from other sample libraries. Most of these patches are self-explanatory, though there are some patch types categorized as single articulations that deserve a bit more explanation, and these are also the reason why ignoring the single articulation patches in favor of the multi-articulations is not a particularly bright idea and comes at the cost of missing some of the best features. General single articulation patches. Most of the single articulation patches are pretty easy to explain, so let's just look at a staccato patch from Berlin Brass Mine Collection. This patch is also a good example of the different views, so we'll use it as a general Capsule Singles 101 subject. Everything in here will be the same for all other single articulation patches, unless a particular feature makes absolutely no sense in a particular articulation. The performance view prominently shows the main knob in the middle, which displays information related to the velocity and dynamics of the articulation. The dynamics abbreviation in the middle represents the currently playing dynamic layer, as recorded in standard music lingo. P for piano, MF for mezzo forte, FF for fortissimo, and everything in between. Because it will always show the recorded layer, this tells you the actual dynamic the instrument is playing, regardless of patch volume. Around the main knob, a colored bar will go in a circle showing the incoming velocity or crossfade setting. This will go through the velocity layers, or adjust volume or a filter if the patch has only one layer. Above the dynamics abbreviation, the crossfade velocity switch toggles between the two ways the velocity layers can be controlled, by keyboard velocity, so how hard you bang on the keys, or by crossfading through the layers with an assignable MIDI CC, usually CC1, the mod wheel. In some collections, there is another option below the dynamics. Dynamic switch, when enabled, does not crossfade through layers, but rather switches between them depending on incoming velocity. This is mostly used for percussion instruments. Below the main knob, the info view shows the name of the articulation as well as the collection and capsule version. Here you will also see some status messages popping up when key switches like round robin reset are engaged. To the right of the patch will be various options depending on the articulation, like tempo controls for tempo sync patches, concertino for strings and more. At the very bottom left of the patch, the transposition and playable range sliders let you transpose the whole instrument. Very useful for playing in a different key, and adjust the range. Recorded notes are shown blue in context keyboard. The extended range is colored yellow and is created by stretching the samples. Extreme stretching will sound noticeably worse, but if you want to extend the range just a little bit beyond what is recorded, the range tool is a great help. The top right has load and save preset buttons, which allow you to save the patch settings to a file to load later. Clicking on the small bar below the buttons opens a menu where you can choose which elements to load, as well whether by default only checked values from the original patch are loaded when loading a preset. In the bottom right, there are buttons to save and load the default preset. The process is identical to the normal presets, but here you do not need to specify a file name. Going to the mixer view, you are greeted with one channel strip per microphone position. Click on the mic name to toggle it on or off. Panorama, solo mute controls, as well as the fader work like in your sequencer mixer. Below all these is the link button. Linked channels perform every action together, so if you move one fader, the linked ones will move too. Below that, you can assign the mic position to a contact output. If no outputs are shown here, make sure you have added enough outputs in Contact Mixer. To the right of the channel strips are a few buttons with special features. Auto Gain makes it so that when you move any fader, the other active faders are moved in the opposite direction to keep the same overall volume. Chain All, Solo All and Mute All do exactly what their names say. The last option, Purge All, is useful in that it lets you purge or reload all mic positions with one click. That brings us to the settings view, where all patch options reside. Depending on the patch, things might look a bit different, or some options may be missing. The layers section lets you switch individual velocity layers on or off. This is useful if you don't need a particular layer in a composition. In dynamics, the niente option makes the instrument go to total silence at zero velocity or crossfade CC. This is best used with a breath or wind controller. See my overview of the Homburg HP1 breath station about that. The link is in the video description as well as here in the video. Soft low layer makes the softest layer slowly rise in volume before the next higher layer comes in, leading to a bigger, quiet range. The lower part of the settings view contains the volume range option for setting how broad the adapted dynamic range of the patch will be, an option to enable the cutoff filter that is adjusted for every articulation separately and can help with music expression, as well as attack and release controls with an adjustable attack curve. The round robin section to the right has a number of useful options, especially for short notes. Round robins are different samples of the same note at the same dynamic. They are triggered in succession when playing fast note repetitions, countering the so-called machine gun effect, where repeatedly hearing the same samples would betray the sampled nature of the performance. The fake neighbor round robin vastly extends the round robin pool by not only using the recorded round robins, but also taking transposed round robins from the surrounding notes. By default, round robins are played in sequence. Random RR makes the selection random, which is especially useful in articulations with a lower number of round robins. If polyphonic round robin is enabled, only one round robin is advanced when playing chords. New note resets round robin does exactly what it says. If enabled, playing a new note makes the round robin sequence start from zero again. This obviously has no effect when random round robins are active. Last but not least, Capsule also lets you specify a time after which the round robin sequence will be reset. Again, this has no effect with random round robin. Each available round robin is represented by a dot in the RR layer section. You can enable or disable individual round robins here. This is very useful if you come across a round robin you don't like. Which brings us to the controller table. This is the control room of Capsule, where you can assign key switches and MIDI CCs to all functions. Features are grouped in categories that are distributed across pages which you can browse via the arrow buttons. Elements that are not used by that particular patch, for example all the multi-articulation settings here, are grayed out. Click on any enabled item to see the settings. You can assign a key switch and or MIDI CC, adjust controller curves with the several presets provided, or draw in your own curve. Most important features have defaults already assigned that are consistent across all collections. This means that, for example, your microphone faders will always be assigned with the same MIDI CC. The controller table settings can be saved in a preset, so it's best to set up everything how you like it in one patch of a collection and then save a preset. You can then load this preset in all other patches. Don't forget to assign the round robin reset to a key switch convenient for your workflow. Capsule uses a special automation system that is different from how Contact usually works. In Contact, you right-click on a UI element to assign it to a MIDI CC. In Capsule, this does not work this way, and a lot of people never realize that this way of direct automation is also possible here. To assign a CC, depending if you're using Windows or macOS, Alt or Option click on the UI element, and Capsule will jump to the correct entry in the controller table and arm it for MIDI learn. Then just move your MIDI controller you want to assign. Make sure to browse through the controller table and adjust things to your workflow to experience the true power of Capsule. Now, after we have seen how Capsule patches work in general, let's have a look at some special single articulation patches that are not available in the multi-articulation patches. Adaptive legato. Most collections have multiple attack variants as well as legato styles. Some collections like Nocturne Violin or Cello actually have 14 legato styles in total. The single articulation legato patches are unique in that they provide the full adaptive legato that reacts to your playing speed, but also incorporate all those attack variants. These are triggered by velocity. So when you play very soft, you get soft attack. When you play very hard, an accented attack is played, with a regular attack in between. Coupled with a full adaptive legato, this makes the single articulation's legato patches the perfect patch to choose for most lines. Trills Orchestrator. Another useful patch type that is only available as a single is the Trills Orchestrator. In these patches, you can play trills by playing the interval on your keyboard and Capsule will trill between the notes. The available range is always shown in the patch name. WT means the patch will trill up to a whole tone. Fifth means it will trill up to a fifth. Some collections even have measure trills that will sync to your host tempo. The Trills Orchestrator allows you to play multiple trills at the same time and has two modes. You can either play pairs of notes or use the second note as the first note of the next trill by switching the respective option in the performance view. Search to singles. Depending on the collection, there are other articulations that are not available inside the multis. These include the Runs Builders in Berlin Woodwinds Legacy and Orchestral String Runs, the Cluster Builders in Berlin Brass Horn Effects, and the Pedal Harp and Symphonic Sphere. Berlin Brass Main Collection has a number of Bells Up patches for the horns that are not available in the multis. So make sure to browse the single articulations, otherwise you might be missing out on some of the best patches. Hidden feature, Mute Instrument. For those that want to stack articulations, there is a not very well known bonus feature in every single articulation patch. The Mute Instrument command can be assigned on the controller table and will mute or unmute your articulation. This is perfect when multiple articulations are loaded on the same MIDI channel as a stack. Give each of them a unique key switch and you can mute or unmute individual articulations in the stack on the fly. A.1. Time Machine Patches. Time Machine Patches are found in the Time Machine folder inside the Instruments folder and are closely related to their normal single articulation counterparts. In fact, they are completely identical in functionality but allow the samples to be time stretched using Contact's Time Machine algorithm. You can make samples slower or faster while preserving the pitch. This is very useful when you want to make a staccato a bit shorter or make a crescendo a bit longer. Only articulations where such time stretching makes sense are available as Time Machine patches. As with most things in life, moderation is best. Extreme stretching values will lead to interesting results. B. Multi-articulation patches. One important thing first. Multi-articulation patches must not be confused with contact multis. Contact multis consist of multiple patches. Multi-articulation patches have, as the name says, multiple articulations in one patch. It is also important to know that Orchestral Tools does not see the multi-articulation patches as simply combining all single articulation patches. There are things single articulation patches can do that the multi-articulation patches cannot, but that is also true the other way around. To understand how multi-articulation patches work and how they are intended to be used, there is one golden rule that you need to learn by heart. If you want to do something that is not possible in any single articulation patch, load a multi-articulation patch and build it yourself. Multi-articulation patches are such not intended as mere key switch providers, though they do that as well, but rather as one special tool in providing things for your workflow. Let's look at one such patch. Here is the first oboe from Berlin Woodwinds Revive. Looking at the settings, mixer, and controller table views, everything looks the same as in the single articulations. The performance view is where most of the difference lies. Every multi-articulation patch has a row of 12 slots to load articulations. While multis generally load with some slots already filled, every articulation can be loaded into any slot in any order. Each articulation can only be loaded once, and slots can be skipped, as shown here in this oboe multi. Individual slots are assigned to sequential key switches, usually starting at C0. You can shift the key switch range with the KS arrows in the bottom left of the patch. You can also switch between slots using a MIDI CC. Assign a CC of your choosing to slot switch CC in the controller table for this. Let's look at the 12 slots in a bit more detail. Loaded slots show an abbreviation of the loaded articulation as well as an icon representing the articulation below the slot name. Empty slots show a row of dots instead of the articulation abbreviation. You can click the icon to select a slot, or use the corresponding key switch. Clicking on a slot name opens a menu with all available articulations that have not yet been loaded into any slot. Generally, there are more than 12 articulations per instrument, by the way. Next to the articulation menu are two little icons. The wrench icon opens the slot settings. This area holds settings for the current slot, whereas the settings view has all the settings that are global for the whole patch. The slot settings have a switch for choosing between velocity or crossfade, show around robin layers, and so on. One big hallmark feature of the multi-articulation patches is also set up here. All multi-articulation patches have the ability to assign legato transitions to any articulation. You can use all regularly available legato styles in up to 3 speed zones. This way you can create tremolo legato by applying legato transitions to a tremolo patch. The second small button next to the articulation menu shows a slur and does exactly what it looks like. It switches legato on or off using the settings made in the slot settings. When a slot is selected, the patch info view at the bottom will show the articulation name. You may ask why that area is so big if only a short articulation name is shown. That is because the true power of the multi-articulation patches lies in the polyphonic key switching. Set the mono poly KS switch to poly, and you are greeted with 4 different poly KS modes. Every mode can use up to 4 slots at the same time. To select slots, simply press up to 4 key switches together, and the patch info view will show the selected articulations. 1. The CC switch mode switches between slots using a MIDI CC. You can set the points at which the slots will switch by changing the threshold in the bottom left of the slots. The CC that is used to switch is defined in the controller table as MI crossfade switch. CC22 is the default, but you can of course change it. 2. Velocity switch is identical to CC switch, but instead of a MIDI CC, key velocity is used to switch between slots. Again, you can adjust the thresholds. 3. The CC crossfade mode, instead of switching between slots based on the incoming CC, crossfades between them. No thresholds are available here. Instead, the available range is divided by the number of slots, which is also the default for the other modes if no changes are made. This mode is very useful to crossfade between vibrato styles, which is not possible in the single articulation patches, or to seamlessly morph from sustain to tremolo. Real musicians can do this effortlessly, and now your sample players can too. 4. Finally, the CC Crossfade 2D mode places 4 slots in a grid and lets you freely morph between them using 1 CC for the x-axis and 1 for the y-axis. You can set both in the controller table. CC22 and 23 are the default. As we've seen, the multi-articulation patches can do stuff the singles cannot, and vice versa. With polyphonic key switching and the ways it lets you combine articulations, by now you have probably seen why that golden rule has its merits. But what about when you have created a new patch like this? By combining articulations, setting thresholds and so on. That's where the locked view comes in. The performance view next to the preset buttons has a little button with a lock on it. Click it and the currently selected slots, with all their settings, will be locked for editing, turning the patch into essentially a new single articulation patch, You even have the main knob in the middle. Because this patch is locked for any outside editing, that means you can load it in your template like a regular single articulation, without the fear of accidentally changing settings. Save it somewhere and over time you can create a whole library of custom articulations tailored to your workflow. I hope you enjoyed this overview of the Capsule framework. Make sure to hit that like button if you did. Capsule is really deep and has a lot to offer, so there might very well be a follow-up video in the future. Let me know your thoughts and feedback in the comments. Of course, I'll be happy to answer any questions you might have. Make sure to stop by orchestraltemplates.com for more template-y goodness. Take care and see you soon.